Hi there folks, in today's demonstration I'm going to show you all the new functionality that's due to drop into Power Automate, some of which is already here, like the format data by example, but also we'll look at the new Cloud Flow Designer, describe it to design it, we've got Copilot functionality, the new Cloud Flow history as part of that new designer, and also the ChatGPT AI model that's coming to AI Builder. So a lot of this is all preview functionality. I fired up my demo environment and I've showcased all this new functionality so you know what's coming up soon. So if that's something you're interested in, make sure you watch, don't forget to subscribe, and without further ado, let's jump into the demonstration. So in order to demonstrate format data by example, I have a flow that's already built here that creates an HTML table, and one of the dynamic values is a received date time. Now I know that the format of that date time is what's known as an ISO 8601 format, but in order to demonstrate that, if I put my flow into test mode and run that flow, we can look at the output that's sent in the email. Jumping over into my email, we can see an example of that received date in that ISO 8601 format. And if I go and highlight and then copy one of these examples with Control C, I can move back across onto Power Automate, into Edit. I can then remove that dynamic value for the received time. And rather than using the dynamic content tab, I can go into the expression tab, select format data by examples, select that received time, and then it'll ask me to provide an example, in which case I can paste in that date time string that I copied from the email, and then the desired output. So I would like to have the 4th of June 2023, and I would like it to output the time as well, so 12:58, but without the seconds. Now when I click on Get Expression, you can see that it's generated an example expression, and as well as being able to add additional examples if the suggested expression is not quite right, I can also test the output. If I jump back onto my email, I can highlight another date, Control C, move back across onto Power Automate, and paste that value in as a test value, and click on Test Expression. We can see that the desired output is as I'd expected. So on this occasion, I'm going to apply this change and accept this new format. In order to test that, I'm going to now put the flow into test mode and we can have a look back at the email that is generated. Over onto Power Automate, we can have a look at that newly generated email and we can see that all of those received dates are now formatted based on that example expression that was generated by Power Automate. Next up, we're going to have a look at this flow in the new designer. So this particular flow is based on a recurrence trigger. It will happen at 9 a.m. every Monday. It gets emails from a shared mailbox, generates an HTML table, and then based on a condition, whether or not there are any emails in that shared folder or not, it will send an email to say there are no emails, or it will send the email with the HTML table that's generated above. If I go back to the details pane and click on the edit button, not only do I have edit with designer, which is a native functionality, I have try the AI powered editing, which will open up both the new editor, but also Copilot. So with the new designer window now open, you'll see on the right hand side, I have the availability of Copilot. And the first thing I'm going to do is to ask it to describe the flow that we currently have in the designer. So let's ask it to describe my flow. Based on the information that I just gave you, this flow is triggered weekly at 9 a.m. on a Monday using a recurrence trigger. It receives up to 25 unread emails from a shared mailbox, creates an HTML table. And if there are no unread emails, it sends an email to specified recipient. Otherwise, it sends an email and posts a message to Teams channel with a number of unread emails and the HTML table. So exactly as I described it prior in the native designer. So if you've recently taken on the role of a new flow and you need to understand what it's all about, maybe the ability to describe my flow is something for you. The main change in the new designer is that when you click on an action, all of the options and parameters open up on the left-hand side, and it's the same view for each of those actions, depending on the parameters, of course. So I've clicked on Get Emails, If I go and click on the HTML table, you'll see that familiar format there with our keys and our values, or our header and values. And of course, I could go into various settings, configure the run after, look at the security if I want to mask any of that input or output, and if I want to add any track properties. So exactly the same sort of functionality that you would see in the native editor, albeit it's all within the one screen. No need to click on ellipsis and go hunting about for different settings. We have the same familiar code view if you want to have a look at the JSON that sits behind each of those actions. And if you want to know a bit more about the action that you've selected, there is an about as well. Now, if I jump back to parameters, unfortunately, this new designer doesn't yet have the format data by examples, so I wouldn't be able to go and generate that formatted date time. But if I go and click on that expression, we can see we have a new expression window, which not only can I make larger, I can also make full screen. So we can now see the full extent of our expressions that have been written for Power Automate. The only other main observation here is that the functions and the dynamic content have switched sides. But of course, this is all preview, so subject to change. So next up, we're gonna have a look at the Describe It to Design It feature, which is pretty much part of Copilot. I can now use natural language processing to create myself a flow. So let's try and create that flow that we've been looking at. So if I click on Describe It to Design It, I get this prompt here, and I'm then able to describe the flow that I'm looking to create. I'm going to do this in stages though. So first off, I'm going to type in send an email every Monday at 9 to include an HTML table in a shared mailbox. So we click on the submit button and let's see what gets generated. So with the designer now loaded, we have our flow and Copilot ready for action. If I click on that table action, let's see if we can maybe get Copilot to add in those custom columns that we required in the previous flow. So I'll ask it the question to add custom columns to the HTML table, and I'll specify those column names from date received and subject, and I'll go ahead and submit that. So we can see that Copilot has updated the table action. If I go and click on that, whilst it's not got it right, it has gone and changed the columns from the default automatic to custom, and it has added in three individual rows there. So I'm actually going to go ahead and ask it once more to do that same thing. So add custom columns to the HTML table and include the from, the date received, and the subject, and we'll submit that again. So again, Copilot has recognized that it needs to update the table action. If I click on that, we can see now that we have the headers from date received and subject. It looks like some dynamic values have been selected, albeit for the eagle-eyed, as I hover my mouse over, we'll see that in fact the expressions are incorrect. So it's worth noting at this point in time that this is very much a preview feature. So what else can we ask Copilot to do? So how about asking it to send a message to a Teams channel? So also send a message to a Teams channel with the HTML table. And we'll submit that and see what comes up next. So again, it looks like Copilot has updated the table action. I'm not quite sure what's been updated on this occasion, but it's also added in the post a message to a chat or a channel. So at least it got that part of my requirement correct. Now the final part that I'd like to do is to send a different email if there are no emails. So we'll go with send a different email if there are no emails in the shared mailbox. And let's see what Copilot comes up with this time. So if I bring that new flow into focus here, we can see that it has updated the logic to include a condition. If I click on that condition, there are no dynamic values in there to specify what that condition is, so it's still for me to determine that it's based on the length of the get emails, but it has correctly added in an email that says no new emails are in the shared mailbox. And on the right-hand side, assuming that there are emails, we still have that HTML table, we're still posting it to our Teams channel, and then finally we have the send an email 3, which is new emails in a shared mailbox. There are new emails in the shared mailbox. So Copilot has correctly helped me with some of the logic. It built that initial flow. It allowed me to make changes using natural language processing. And whilst it's not been that great at putting together expressions and adding dynamic content, it will inevitably get better because this is a preview feature. So make sure if you are using this, you do go down the preview route. If you want to preview it, make sure you have that US preview environment, which is one of the requirements of finding and using this feature. But also, if you do end up using it, make sure you use this like or dislike so you can provide feedback based on the flows that have been created. Now, one other feature, which I think is quite useful, is the ability to actually just ask general questions. So we saw already that we can ask it to describe a flow. So if we go down the route here of asking Copilot to describe this flow, it should be quite similar to before. It checks for emails in the shared mailbox at 9 a.m. and plays out that logic. That all looks good to me. But also, I can ask it questions like, what day is it today? And you'll be surprised to see that, in fact, it comes back and confirms that, in fact, I can only answer questions about Power Automate and those that are written in English. Next up, it wouldn't be Power Automate without looking at the flow history. So let's see what that looks like on the new designer. So I've gone and fired up that original that I built by hand. I'll put it into test mode and we can have a look back at the flow history and see what improvements might be about to come up here. So very much like the old history, you're able to go and click on the triggers or the actions, but instead of seeing the progress on those individual actions, we now have that similar pop-up on the left-hand side with those properties that have been captured, the run times, and I can have a look at various inputs and outputs for all the different actions that have been run throughout this process. If I pop open the condition, I know you're gonna ask me, can you see what the two values are of the expression? Not currently, no. Still showing true or false, but hopefully that's a feature that'll come as part of this new update. And then finally, last but not least, ChatGPT. Where would we be without it? Well, it's coming to AI Builder, and there's a preview model that you can use here that will create text, summarize documents, and more. Now, if I click on it, I have this lovely playground. I can go and pick some samples, for instance, summarize text. And if I was to jump over onto this blog post here, you'll see I've highlighted a whole chunk of text, which I'm going to now copy, bring that back across here into the playground, and paste it into this prompt, and we'll test it out and see what GPT can generate for us. So we get a lovely little summary there based on that text that I provided, as you'd expect with ChatGPT. But what does that mean? Well, if I click on this button here to use a pre-built model, I can use it in an app or a flow. Let's go ahead and build a flow. And using one of the inbuilt templates, I can go ahead and click continue. And before we know it, we've got the framework of a new flow that will use that create a text with a GPT preview action, take some text as an input from that flow, start an approval to make sure that the summary that's been provided is acceptable. And then based on the outcome, it will either notify the end user that it was accepted or in fact was rejected. And then just so I can do a demo, I've tidied up the flow by removing the approval. I've added in a compose that will have the text as the output here. We'll put it into test. We can paste in that text from the blog post, run the flow, and then we'll be able to look at that output that's been generated from the create text with GPT action, with the output text being provided in our compose there.